Something came up today that was so helpful that I have to share it with you right away. And let's get right to it. You know, I've been advancing this narrative about what existence is. Existence is an attempt on the part of spirit to develop a power that it can use to strong arm the prime creator into changing reality. And the plan is that we are going to make a deal with the prime creator and say, look, prime creator, we have the power of destructivity and we're going to destroy all of reality, but we'll make a deal with you. And if you only change a little bit of reality for us, just a little, the tiniest bit, we'll call it even. And let's make a deal on that. And we won't destroy all of reality. That is the narrative. That is what I am saying is the situation we're in. Existence is the attempt to manufacture a power of destructivity, which is why we have all sickness, dying, death, loss, all of that. And I have said that the prime creator cannot change even the tiniest bit of reality. And I ask the question, the most important question we can ask is, can the prime creator change reality or cannot change reality? Which is it? Either the prime creator can change reality or cannot change reality. Which is it? It can't be both, right? It cannot be both. The prime creator cannot change reality and also not change reality. You know, one of these two has to be true and the other has to be false. That is the essence of inquiry right there. Okay. And I have said that the prime creator cannot change reality. But you still have to, you know, ask yourself and try to see which is true and which is false. But I'm going to give you a key. A key came to me just like about an hour and a half ago while I was working. And it's tremendous because I've said that the prime creator cannot change even the tiniest bit of reality, or else all reality is nullified. And let me explain why this is very clearly. Let us say the prime creator, the creation is endless, and it is. But even if we're not sure of this, we can say for the purpose of this clarification, let's take that as hypothetically, the creation is endless. That is reality. The creator, prime creator, created endless freedom, endless spontaneous creativity, endless ideas, okay, endlessness, never ending, and that is reality. Reality is never ending. Okay. Now let us say we went to the prime creator and said, we want you to change reality just a tiny bit. Okay. Now here's the question. If endlessness could be changed, what possible change could take place with endlessness? What possible change could you make? Even the tiniest change, what change could ever take place with endlessness? That is the question. And when I asked myself that question, the question sort of came into my mind. I said, oh my gosh, the only way that endlessness could possibly be changed is that it would have to come to an end, right? Do you see that? It would have to be an end point to endlessness. That's the only way you could change it, isn't it? And when you see this, literally, you have salvation in your hand. Okay, it is the smoking gun. It really is. Because what we're asking Prime Creator then, if we're saying Prime Creator, we want you to change reality just the tiniest bit, the only way the Prime Creator could change reality is to have an end to endlessness, which means there would be an end point to reality, right? And that we're saying that's exactly what we want, because we want reality to end and we want a new reality to begin with us as Prime Creator. Okay? That is the fact. The idea, we wanted to be prime creator, and we had to bring reality to an end in order for this to happen. Okay, because in reality, we're not prime creator. So we have tried to make an end run, a clever end run. And now we're saying to the prime creator, look, prime creator, look at all this evidence that we've accumulated throughout eons. And in this hypothetical scenario of existence, how we've destroyed everything. Everything, we can destroy anything. and we can even destroy reality now. And you need to make a deal, but we're going to cut you the best deal imaginable. You only have to change reality the tiniest bit, the most minuscule bit, as a sign of your goodwill toward us. Okay, but even the most minuscule change to endlessness has to be what? It has to be an end to endlessness. Either endlessness is endless, or it is not endless. And if it's not endless, it means there's an end to it. So we're literally telling the Prime Creator, look, you need to put an end to reality. That's why I say if the Prime Creator could change reality at all, it would reality would be no more, because there'd be an end to it. There'd be an end to it, you see? And so the very reality is endless. That's what it is. So if there's an end to it, it's not reality anymore. And the entire situation would be completely gone. The complete safety, the complete freedom, everything, the whole experience of reality would literally no longer be real at all, if you see. So therein lies the whole trick. And I use the coined word trickeration. It's probably not in Webster's, but it's a good word. That's the trickeration that we're using. Okay, and we can easily now see exactly what it is. Is we're saying just the tiniest bit, but even the tiniest change to endlessness would be what? It would be an end. There is no other change you could make to endlessness other than having an end to it. We might say, well, the end would be in, you know, billions, trillions and trillions and trillions of years. Still an end. It would completely nullify the entire experiencing of the whole reality. Nullify it, because there's an end to it. And then what, right? So we'd be thinking, oh my gosh, what are we going to do when it ends? That's right. See, very tricky, but not at all fooling the Prime Creator. Okay, not at all fooling really us, spirit. I've been able to see it. I'm spirit, you're spirit, we're all spirit. So we can all see this. It's not that tough. How can you change endlessness? How can you change endlessness, you see? What's the only way? The only way to change it is for it to not be endless. We can't have it more than endless. We can't change it that way, right? If we were to say, let's make endlessness even more. No. Okay, that's a fake, isn't it? That'd be delusion. And, you know, maybe we try to hide our purpose by saying, oh no, we're just trying to make endlessness more. No, there is no such thing as more to endlessness. It's already endless. There is no more to it. So the only way that we could conceive of changing endlessness is if it had an end point to it, if it came to an end. That's the only way. You don't change something by just restating what it is, maybe using different terminology. That's not a change. We don't say, well, more endlessness. That's just a repetition of the same term. Endlessness is endless moreness already. So that's not asking for any change at all. But if we said, well, we're going to put an end to endlessness at some point, that would be the only change you could make. And literally, that's the change we're asking the Prime Creator to make, so that this reality in which we are not Prime Creator, that reality could come to an end, and then a new reality somehow, apparently, we believe that we would have the power to create a new reality once this reality came to an end, and we try to figure that one out, and be the Prime Creator. That is it. So I'm putting all this up front in this video. So if those of you who don't want to continue listening on, you know, if you've got it now, okay? And you can consider it on your own if you want to. And for the others, I will see if I can continue on here, moving the narrative forward. It's a great day. It is a great day because this confirmation that this narrative is right on the mark by this insight that just came to me. I wasn't, you know, just boom, there it was. And I just looked at it and said, it was crystal clear. And I said, thank you, thank you, thank you, because this is corroboration that this narrative, this whole scenario that I'm talking about, that first Spirit had the idea of wanting to be Prime Creator. Okay, then it had to figure out how to bring endlessness to an end, reality to an end. It couldn't do it itself, so it believed that Prime Creator had to do it. And so it had to try and then find a way to threaten, force Prime Creator into doing it. Because Prime Creator wouldn't do it voluntarily. We'd ask, and Prime Creator, no. He said, I cannot change. Because to change endlessness means to bring reality to an end. Can't do it. But we thought, no, Prime Creator's only bluffing. Prime Creator's only bluffing. So we're going to threaten Prime Creator. We're going to force Prime Creator. We're going to say, Prime Creator, we're going to destroy reality if you don't change it a little bit for us. And that is why we have been working on trying to manufacture a power of destructivity, that reality can be destroyed. And what are we doing? We're just symbolizing reality and then destroying the symbols. That's all we're doing. Existence is symbolic. Energy is symbolic. Everything in existence, the whole dance of energy, is symbolic. Ananda Maima said that even though the dance of existence continues on endlessly and endlessly and endlessly, said what she is remains untouched, meaning that the divine is untouched by energy. It's not energy. It's not touched by it at all. Reality is not energy. It's essence. It's idea and essence, okay? It's not energy. And so the dance of energy is just symbolic. And in this dance of energy, everything can be killed. And everything is killed. We're simply killing everything. Existence is cannibalizing itself, is what it's doing. It's devouring itself, ceaselessly devouring the worm Ouroboros, you know, ceaselessly devouring itself. That is existence. That's what it is. And through doing this, we're trying to build up some kind of real powers to destroy reality and then threaten the Prime Creator with that and then force the Prime Creator to change reality a little bit for us. In other words, bring an end to reality so that then a new creation can take place and we're Prime Creator. That is the whole thing in a nutshell. And it doesn't need to be any more complex than that, because that's exactly what's going on. And, of course, the Prime Creator cannot bring an end to endlessness. No power. And we cannot create any power to harm reality whatsoever. We don't, because the Prime Creator did not give us the authority to create a power, to create a new law of reality, a law of destructivity. No such thing in reality. The law of death, loss, no such thing. No such law. There's no such thing as loss or death in reality. None. And we don't have the power to do it. We ask the mind, Spirit asks the mind to create this power. And mind says, okay, because mind's the perfect servant, but mind can't do it. Mind can't do it. Cannot do it. And so we ceaselessly toil in existence trying to come up with this power and thinking we have it, you know, and trying it, testing it out on each other is what we really do. The universe, the existence is just a sacrificial workshop, you know. All it is this massive, constant sacrifice of we're testing out this power of loss on each other, on everything. Everything gets destroyed, everything. And we think that we're helping each other out, saying, yeah, sure, you wipe me out, next time I'll wipe you out, we'll work together, and we'll all go in this collective sacrifice, and we'll build the power of loss, and we'll prove it to ourselves. And once we prove it to ourselves, and we know it's a true power, then we can then go to the Prime Creator and say, okay, we created this new power. You don't have it, Prime Creator, but we figured out a way to create it. So this existence is like a workshop. It's a workshop on death, on dying, on sacrifice, on loss, on destruction. And of course, we have to construct all this stuff in order to then destroy it, obviously. And so we can't do it. We cannot create a power. It's not possible. And yet we keep thinking that we can, because we say, surely, you know, something must have come of all this dying and death and destruction. Everything that's ever arisen in existence has also been destroyed, you know, swept away into nothingness. So we think, wow, there must be a power here. It's not. It's only our imagination. It's the play of mind. Mind is our servant, and we told mind, this is the idea. We want to be prime creator. We want, therefore, you must come up with a way to bring an end to reality. So you must come up with this power. And so mine says, you know, yes, master, I will do that. And is presenting this incredibly variated situation in time and space where there's just endless variations on basic theme of loss, of destruction. Endless themes of it. All of it futile. Futile. Doesn't add up to anything. It's like zero times whatever is still zero. If we don't have the authority or the capability to create a power, a new law of reality, therefore, it's our ability is zero. So no matter how much we try, it's still zero. We can multiply all these symbolic deaths infinitely. It's still zero. No power whatsoever. There's none. So what we're doing is we're saying, yeah, that's exactly what we've been doing. Yeah, we've been trying to trick the prime creator. Yeah, we said, oh, only a little bit, right? Little bit. A little bit of change in endlessness is the same as a lot of change in endlessness, right? It still means the end to endlessness. Either there's endlessness or there's not endlessness. It means there's a point where there's some, you know, some change or something that doesn't continue on. It has to be that way. And the prime creator is perfectly aware of it, of course. So we're not fooling anyone except ourselves, which doesn't count. Because the one we're trying to fool is the prime creator. So we can fool ourselves endlessly, and we do. You know, like it's like we're saying, well, we believe it, prime creator. We believe in the power of loss, so you must believe it too, right? Right? You know, that kind of thing. 1 minute here, just a second. Okay, and of course we're just fooling ourselves. You know, we're believing in it, saying, "Yeah, we believe it. Wow, look at all this loss. We really believe it. Really believe it." Hoping that, you know, by convincing ourselves it's true, we can then be convincing to the prime creator, and the prime creator will believe it. You know, nah, because prime creator is onto our scheme from the very beginning, entirely. It's simple. We want to bring an end to reality. It's just that simple. And of course we're going to go to the prime creator and say, prime creator, we know this power, you know, we've suffered under this terrible new power of death and it's destroyed us. So, you know, certainly it can destroy you too, that kind of thing. Look at this whole kingdom is destroyed. All of existence has been destroyed or whatever. You know, prime creator will say, well, but those are just fantasies that you're destroying, mirages. It's not reality. You're not destroying reality. You're just setting these things up, that nothing up, in very various forms of nothing, and then resolving them back to nothing, and just a play of energy, play of your imagination. You don't have any power to destroy reality, and I cannot make a deal with you at all, because endlessness, you cannot make any deal. Even the slightest change would mean an end to reality, so it's not possible. What you're trying to do is not possible. So see that. Just see it and give up. And you can take as long as you want to see this, to see that. Just you have to use your honesty and clarity and understanding and voice of reason and be able to just recognize and see it. Ah, okay. And the prime creator just laughing and smiling and saying, welcome home, welcome back, welcome back, welcome back. And you'll just say, oh, okay, I know exactly what I was trying to do, and I know it can never work, and completely silly, utterly silly. No harm, no foul. Prime Creator's not upset. Prime Creator certainly is glad for us to return to our sanity and stop pursuing a course of insanity, of futility, really. Glad, very glad. Glad for us. Glad for all of creation, because all of creation, you know, can flow and, you know, flow even more abundantly when we're not pursuing this mad quest to end reality. Reality is not affected by it, but the Prime Creator certainly knows that we are not full of the delight that we were created to be. It's sort of like the delight is we're unaware of it. We're unaware of it. because we're pursuing this scheme. We're pursuing this scheme. And so that's the totality of the situation, and it becomes simpler and simpler when we see it this way. You connect the dots and you say, oh my gosh, wow. All right, we can end this one now. It's not a problem. And maybe we'll do some more videos later. But let's keep this one short and so you can let it sink in. All right, very great. That's it for this video.